Good morning, students. Welcome to this first face-to-face class. Well, my name is Elena Cifuentes, and I'm a tutor of Pearson Academy. This PowerPoint presentation, or I have a PowerPoint presentation for students of first level modalidad presencial and first and second level modalidad distancia. All right, so you know this first face-to-face class is to review the most important topics about grammar you have studied. So, my dear students, I would like to know, all right, which are the grammar topics you don't understand? Okay, you have a microphone, so please, could you tell me which are the problems you have about the grammar? Yeah, I see some students from Machala, I think from Ibarra, El Puyo, and some other centers. Okay, do you have questions about the grammar? Which are the topics you have problems? Well, here I have a PowerPoint presentation with these topics. The verb be, indefinite articles, how to form plural forms, the use of prepositions, possessive nouns, possessive adjectives, information questions, the use of have and has, imperatives, and the use of this, that, these, and those. But I would like to know from these topics what you don't understand. Hello. Chicos, ¿sí me comprenden? A ver. Quisiera saber cuáles son los puntos gramaticales que ustedes tienen o han tenido inconvenientes hasta la presente. ¿Ok? So, tomen su micrófono, por favor, y quisiera tomar un listado de los puntos gramaticales que ustedes tienen inconvenientes. Esta presentación PowerPoint es para estudiantes de primer nivel, modalidad presencial y primero y segundo nivel de estudiantes modalidad distancia. Los puntos gramaticales que hemos cubierto hasta la presente fecha son estos, ¿no? El uso del verbo to be, de indefinite articles, plural forms, etc. But, quisiera saber qué puntos específicos ustedes tienen o han tenido inconvenientes. A ver, vamos a tomar el micrófono y van a hacer las preguntas, ¿ok? So, please, I'd like to know who are you. Could you introduce yourself, please? Yeah? A ver, ¿dónde están los chicos? Veo un grupo de unas cinco chicas. A ver, vamos a tomar el micrófono, por favor. Tomamos el micrófono, nos vamos a presentar. Obviously, in English. Yes. Okay, try to use your English. Remember, this is a face-to-face class to practice our speaking. Yeah. Good morning. Okay. Yeah. Good morning. What's your name? Vamos, chicos, todos vamos a participar. Todos nos vamos a presentar, ¿ok? Así.
Profe, buenos días.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning. Yo tengo una pregunta. Tengo yo muchos inconvenientes con los imperativos.
Okay, ya. Imperatives. Hola. About the imperatives, please, could you tell me what's your name? Where are you from?
Mi nombre es Vladimir Molina y estoy en el centro de Ibar.
All right, but hey, remember we are in an English class, so you have to say, hello everyone, my name is ta ta ta, and I'm from Ibarra. Okay?
Okay. Hello, my name is Vladimir Molina. I am from Ibar.
Okay, and I have problems with imperatives. Very good. Thank you. Another student?
Thank
Good morning, teacher. My name is Enrique Benalcázar. I'm from Ibarra.
All right. And which are, please, could you tell me what's your problem about grammar?
Bueno, la verdad es que todavía no me ha llegado material, no he podido revisar absolutamente nada. Estoy asistiendo a la tutoría precisamente para adquirir conocimientos, porque no me matriculé ya en forma extraordinaria, entonces he tenido ese inconveniente.
Okay, ¿pero estás trabajando en plataforma?
No me llegaba nada todavía en la plataforma. Inclusive mandé por WhatsApp, pero no me llegó nada.
¿Quién es tu tutor?
No tengo el nombre, no recuerdo.
A ver, por favor, permíteme saber tus nombres. Nombres, número de cédula y en qué nivel estás. A ver, para poder identificar. Luis Enrique.
Luis Enrique Alcázar Pillajo.
Del
¿Qué?
Alcázar.
Sí, Ben Alcázar Pillajo.
Pillajo, ¿qué más?
100, 190, 218, 6.
190, 2, 18, 6. ¿Y estás en primer nivel?
Primer nivel y tomando primer nivel de inglés, pero estoy en noveno de abogacía.
¿Primer nivel distancia o presencial?
A distancia.
Primer nivel
Estoy
distancia.
en noveno ciclo a distancia, pero estoy tomando recién inglés.
All right. Ah, sí, tú eres de distancia, ya. Voy a consultar, voy a pasar tu dato para que tu tutor se ponga en contacto contigo. Lo que pasa es que algunas estudiantes tienen reportado mal su correo electrónico en la base de datos de UTPL, por tanto, todos los datos, la información que estamos enviando a sus correos obviamente no les está llegando, porque debe haber algún error en el correo electrónico. Entonces vamos a verificar y voy a ponerte, voy a pasar el reporte, ¿ya? No ha recibido material. Es decir, tú no has recibido ningún mensaje de tu tutor.
Correo únicamente la convocatoria para esta capacitación o tutoría.
Ok. All right. No problem.
Listo.
¿Ya? Anyone else? ¿Alguien más? Vamos, chicos. Quiero saber cuáles son los problemas que han tenido en lo relacionado a la gramática. Ok.
Buenos días, teacher.
Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Mabel Herrera, from Puyo. Yo solamente he tenido problemas con los imperativos. De ahí, absolutamente todo lo tengo bien claro. Pero esa parte, la tutora de mi plataforma sí me trató de ayudar, pero la verdad es que no lo entendí mucho.
All right, no problem. Okay, you're welcome. Imperatives. What else? Vamos, más chicos.
Good morning, teacher.
Morning.
My name Ruby Isabel Tipán Escobar. My from Guaranda.
Yeah, you have to say my name is.
Okay.
If you
My
don't
name is.
use the verb be, the sentence is incorrect. In Spanish, we don't say mi nombre Eliana. No. En español, ¿qué decimos? Mi nombre es Eliana. So in English, we have to use the verb be. My name is. I'm from Uganda. All right. Yeah. Let's continue.
Mi inconveniente son con los imperativos.
I have problems with imperatives. Right, excellent. So, what else?
Mande.
No more students? Well, I'd like to know all of you. Vamos, todos los chicos en la clase se van a presentar. Todos quiero que me digan sus nombres. Vamos pasando el micrófono uno por uno. All right.
Listen, buenos días. Mi nombre es Guido García. Estoy.
Wait, please. This is an English class, so try to speak in English. You have to say, good morning, everyone. My name is. I'm from Ibarra. I'm from Loja. I'm from Guayaquil, etc. Yeah?
Good morning, teacher. My name is Guido Napoleón García. Soy estudiante de la UTPL Guaranda.
Yeah, all right, Guaranda.
I am
Thank
from.
You.
Okay, gracias.
I'm
Thank
from Guaranda. Thank you. One more. Students in Guaranda.
Good morning, teacher. My Good name morning. Is Alejandra Tibán. I'm from Cayambe.
Cayambe, thank you. Yeah? More students in Cayambe?
Good morning, Hello? Teacher.
Yeah?
My name is Miriam. I'm from Cayambe.
Thank you. I'm. We have to say I'm. Name. We have to pronounce letter M. We say, my name is, my name is, etc. Yeah, let's continue. More students.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Alexandra Huera. I am from Ibarra City.
All right, thank you. Welcome to this class. Someone else in Ibarra?
Good morning, teacher. Mi nombre es Sonia Rosero. I'm from Tulcán.
I'm from Tulcán. Yeah, thank you, Tulcán. Continue, the next.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Yolanda Farinango. I'm from Ibarra City.
I'm. Hey, pronounce letter M. I'm from Ibarra. Thank you.
Good
morning. Yes. Good morning.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Angélica Rodríguez. Soy de San Lorenzo.
Para decir yo soy de San Lorenzo, decimos I am from San Lorenzo.
I am from San Lorenzo.
Excellent. Yeah. No more? No more.
Hello, teacher.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Roman Mauricio Vázquez García. I am from Ibarra.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
My name is Jasmine Echeverría. I am from Latacunga.
All right, thank you, Latacunga.
Hi, teacher. My name is Tania Condorcana. I'm from Latacunga.
All right, thank you. Yeah, more students?
Good morning. I am Edgar Duran. I'm from Latacunga.
I'm. Hey, please, my dear students, we have to pronounce letter M. Clearly, we say, I'm Eliana, I'm from Latacunga, I'm. Remember, pronunciation of letter R. Yes?
Good morning, teacher. My name is Narcisa. I am from Latacunga.
All right, thank you. Narcisa, welcome.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, teacher. Okay.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, teacher. I am Edison Chicaiza. I'm from Latacunga.
Okay, I'm from Latacunga. Right. Now, continue the next.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Carlos Alberto. I am from Esmeraldas.
Thank you, Carlos Alberto. Welcome to this first face-to-face class. Well?
Good morning, teacher. My name is Narcisa, de Esmeraldas.
I'm from Esmeraldas. I'm from Esmeraldas. Thank you.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Ruth Chuquimarca. I am from Tena.
Tena, all right. Excellent.
Good morning, teacher. My name is Nancy Ushka. I am from Tena City.
All right. Thank you.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
My name is Vanessa Prado. I am from Loja.
Right, excellent. From Loja. Yeah, no more students?
Hello, good morning, teacher. My name is Paola. I'm from Mendez. Thank you.
Where is Mendez?
I'm Provincia Morona, Santiago.
I'm Morona, Santiago. Thank you. Welcome. Yeah, more students?
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
My name is Margarita. I am from Macas.
From Macas. Welcome, Macas. Yeah, no more? Okay. I think we don't have more students.
Good morning, teacher. I am Diana Ayala. I'm from in Tulcán.
My dear, we say, I'm from Tulcán. Because if you say, I am from in Tulcán, tú dices, yo soy de en Tulcán. So, preposition in, it is incorrect. I'm from Tulcán. That's it. All right? Now, pay attention to the pronunciation of some words. Remember, sounds in Spanish are different from sounds in English. In Spanish, we pronounce rosa, and we say Rosa Ramírez. The letter R in Spanish is R. It is a vibrating sound. R. Rosa Ramírez, ratón. But in English, pronunciation of letter R, it is different. Hey, dear students, pay attention to pronunciation of letter R. To pronounce this letter, we have to double the tongue. Para pronunciar la letra R en inglés, doblamos la lengua y tratamos de topar el paladar. Y pronunciamos something like R. Repeat, everyone. R. R. This is the pronunciation of letter R. R. And we say air, ear, or, ur. O decimos ra, re, ri, ro, ru. This is the pronunciation of letter R in English. We say verb, verb, article, plural, preposition. And we say information. Imperative, This is the letter R in English. Do you understand? Try to practice pronunciation of letter R. Do you understand? Yes? Yes. Okay. So, some students talk about problems with imperative sentences. No more questions about verbi, about indefinite articles, about prepositions. No, everything is clear. Todo, a ver, chicos, ¿tenemos inconvenientes con el uso del verbo to be? cómo formar oraciones negativas, afirmativas, ¿todo está claro? ¿No? Okay. So, we're going to have a very short review about the use of this verb be, about the use of verb be in affirmative sentences, in negative sentences, in questions, and we are going to have a lot of examples of imperatives. Do you agree? ¿Están de acuerdo? Hagamos una revisión rápida de estos contenidos gramaticales que ustedes han revisado hasta la presente fecha y vamos a hacer ejemplos, varios ejemplos son con imperativos. Porque la mayoría o algunos de ustedes me han mencionado que tenemos problemas con el uso de los imperativos. ¿Algún otro problema específico que no comprendan bien? Yes or no? No? Okay. Now, let's practice. Let's continue. Here we have some questions to greet people. What is the meaning of greet people? Greet means, what is greet? No? Quisiera que los chicos tuvieran el micrófono a la mano para que puedan contestar, ¿ok? Si no entendemos, por favor, inmediatamente toman el micrófono y me dicen, no entiendo, I don't understand. O, what's the meaning of this? O, what is the meaning of that? ¿Cuál es el significado de greet? Ok, vamos, todos, alguien tenga en cada grupo, en cada curso, tengan su micrófono a la mano para no demorarnos mucho y tratar de participar todos a la vez, ok? So, do you understand what is the meaning of greet? Greet, it is when we say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to greet people, we say, hi students, or we say, good morning, dear students, or we say, how are you, or we can say, how's everything, or how's it going. There are different forms to greet people. If you greet a person who is a very close friend, how do we say? ¿Cómo le saludamos a un amigo que es muy cercano? ¿Cómo le decimos? ¿Good morning? ¿O le decimos hi? ¿O hello? Le decimos hi. Hi, Maria. Hello, Fernando. And we say, how are you? How are you? How's everything? How's it going? So, how is it going, Luis Enrique? How's everything, Luis Enrique? Try to use these other forms to greet people, okay? Son otras formas de saludar, para no solo decir, hello, teacher, good morning, teacher, o no solamente decir, hi, o good evening. Podemos decir estas formas. How's everything? How's it going? All right? And the answer could be great. How are you? Great. How's everything? Not bad. How's it going? You can answer, oh, so-so. Not bad. Great. Excellent. I'm okay. Etc. Okay? The common question. We say, what's your name? Can you see the presentation? Right? I think I lost the... Okay. Right. And we say, what's your name? What's your first name? What's your first name? And I say, my first name is Eliana. Pay attention, the pronunciation, it is no first. We don't say first, my first name. No, incorrect. Letter E, it is pronounced with a short E. We say first. My first name is Eliana. First. For your speaking task, remember, you have to pronounce correctly. You say, first. My first name is Eliana. What's your last name? Last name, por si acaso, last name no es el segundo nombre. Last name, it is, in my case, Cifuentes. So, my last name is Cifuentes. Enrique, what's your last name? Enrique, what's your last name? Where is Enrique? Hello, Enrique.
Hi.
Hi, what's your last name, Enrique?
My last name, Benalcázar.
Pay attention. You have to say, my last name is Benalcázar.
My last name is Benalcázar.
Yeah, name. We pronounce name. My last name is Benalcázar. Excellent. Diana, where is Diana? What's your last name, Diana?
My last name is Ayala.
Name. Repeat name. Again. Name.
My last name is Ayala.
Ayala. All right. My last name is Ayala. Remember, we have to use the verb be. Si digo my last name Ayala, estoy diciendo solo mi apellido Ayala. In Spanish, we don't say it like that. Say, my last name is Cifuentes. Another common question. Where are you from? Where are you from? In my case, I'm from Ecuador. I'm from Ambato. I'm from Guaranda. I'm from Guayaquil. I'm from Esmeraldas. Remember, I'm. Pronounce letter M. I'm from. La letra R en inglés se pronuncia R. 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 From. I'm from Ecuador. I'm from Ecuador. Right? Okay. What do you do? This is another question, a common question. What is what you do? When we use this question, what do you do? The answer, it is the profession or the occupation of a person. This question doesn't mean ¿qué haces tú? But this refers to the occupation. O sea, ¿qué haces pero de ocupación? Cuando ustedes escuchen esta pregunta, what do you do? La respuesta será la ocupación que usted tiene. So, what do you do? In my case, I say, I'm a teacher. I'm a doctor. I'm an engineer. I'm a student. I'm a lawyer. I'm a secretary. So, what do you do? All right. Tell me something about you. What do you do? Vamos. Enrique, what do you do?
I'm a policeman.
All right. I'm a policeman. Very good. We say, I'm a policeman. Right. Another student? Thank you, Enrique. Another student? Vamos en el mismo grupo, todos.
I'm a teacher.
I'm a teacher, right.
I am a auxiliar contable.
Accountant. I'm an accountant. Assistant accountant. Yeah. Right, excellent. I'm an assistant accountant. Yeah.
What I am assistant administrative.
We use an. Si ven esta palabrita a o an, this is an indefinite article. With professions, we have to use a o an. In Spanish, en español decimos, ah, yo soy doctor, yo soy ingeniero, yo soy arquitecto. But in English, we need to use this word a. I am a teacher, I am a doctor, I am an engineer, I am an assistant, etc. Yeah, more students.
I'm a paramedic de el 911.
All right. You are a kind of assistant? A kind of nurse? A kind of doctor, maybe?
No, I am a paramedic.
Paramedic, that's a profession. All yes. Right. Okay, I'm a paramedic. Yeah, we learn more. Yeah, what else?
I'm a student.
I'm a student. Excellent. So we say I'm a. Now, what is a? Here we have Sydney is a city. A, it is an article. We call a is an article. This word a, it is used only with singular nouns. Hey, pay attention to this. A, it is an article and it is used with singular nouns, not with plural. And we say, Brazil is a country. Peru is a country. Santiago is a city. Now, look at this word. An. A butterfly. You know, this is a butterfly. This is the butterfly. A butterfly is an insect. What happened here with the word an? Aquí tengo a y aquí tengo an. A and an, they have the same meaning. Tienen el mismo significado. A means un, uno, una. An means un, uno, una. Las dos palabras significan un, uno, una. So, what's the difference? Right? They are called indefinite articles. And what's the difference? We use a in front of consonants. And we say, a teacher, a woman, a singer, a lion, a banker, a musician. This is a teacher. Sometimes the pronunciation, it is like a woman, a singer, a lion, a banker, a musician. In front of consonants. And we use n in front of vowel sounds. Say an engineer, an egg, an architect, an elephant, an oven, an ear. But both words means un, uno, una. Un ingeniero, una ingeniera. Un arquitecto, una arquitecta, un elefante, un oreja. So, a and an, they have the same meaning. The difference is that a, it is before a consonant, and is before of vowel sounds. You see? Now we say, an apple is a fruit. An apple is a fruit. A bear is an animal. Here we have a. And here we have an before a vowel, a before a consonant. Remember, a and an, it is only used, or they are only used with singular nouns, no with plural. We don't say a students. ¿Por qué? Porque estaríamos diciendo un estudiantes, un doctores. A and an, it is only used with singular nouns. Rose is a flower. A rose is a flower. Come on, let's continue. What do you say? Let's complete. Hey, where is your microphone? Take your microphones. ¿Dónde están los micrófonos? A ver, chicos.
And school is building.
Yeah, school. School. We say, here we have the consonant, letter S. So, what's the correct form? A. We say, a school is a building, because B, it is a consonant. What about this?
Horse,
yeah.
Is an animal.
A horse is an animal. Pronunciation of this word, it is ol, animal. A horse is an animal. Excellent. And what about this? Hello. Continue.
An is an insect.
An ant is an insect. Excellent. And sucker.
Soccer is a sport.
Yeah. Pero, hey, chicos, la R, la letra R en inglés no es la misma que en español. En español diríamos soccer, sport. But in English we say R. Soccer is a sport. R, sport. Try to pronounce the letter R. In English, soccer is a sport. All right, good. A printer is a?
A printer is a machine.
Machine. Okay, square is a? Square is a? Come on.
Is a shape.
Shape. Excellent. A triangle is a shape. A circle is a shape. Yeah. A house is a? A house is a?
A house is a building.
Building. Pronunciation, building. A house is a building. A triangle. Continue, a triangle.
A triangle is a shape.
Shape, repeat. Triangle. A triangle is a shape. Okay. A triangle is a shape. Now, let's talk about plural forms. Remember, in N, they are only used with singular nouns, no with plural. Now, let's see about plurals. If we want to talk about in plural, we add the letter S to the noun and we say ducks are birds. Birds in plural. Pay attention to this. Ducks, do you understand what is the meaning of duck? Duck, this is a duck. Hey, here we have one duck, two ducks. These are ducks. Ducks, it is in plural. As we are using the plural in the subject, we use a plural verb. And obviously, birds, it is in plural. We say, in singular, a dog, an animal, a cat, a car, a student, in singular. To form plural, only in singular. Now, to form plural, we add the letter S. We add the letter S to the noun. We say, dogs, animals. Pero ya no digo a dogs, porque estaría diciendo un perros, un animales. En singular utilizo a y an. En plural ya no utilizo a o an, solamente la S del plural. Right. Now, there are some rules to form the plural. Example. If the word, if the noun ends in the letter Y, pay attention to city, country, okay? To form the plural, we omit the letter Y, and then we add ES, and this is the plural, cities. In singular, a city, a country. In plural, we say two cities, three countries, four countries, etc. Cities. Si nos fijamos en esta regla gramatical, cuando el sustantivo termina en la letra Y, omito la letra Y, cambio por I y aumento ES. Y el plural sería cities. Country, countries. Italian bees are countries. Bees and ants are bugs. Now, this is in singular and changing to the plural. The complete sentence changing to the plural. We say, a school is a building in singular. Now, what about the plural? Change into the plural. What do you say? Vamos, dígame. What? Sorry, could you speak aloud? ¿Y dirías cómo?
Schools are buildings.
Excellent. We say schools are buildings. In this case, pay attention to this, the use of the. El artículo definido the o de, no digo the schools are buildings, ¿por qué? El de o the significa el, la, los, las. The is used to talk about specific things. Cuando quiero especificar algo, ahí digo the schools. Cuando especifico las escuelas, las escuelas de Guaranda, todas las escuelas de Guaranda, estoy especificando al grupo escuelas, ahí digo the schools. Pero si estoy hablando de manera general, in a general way, we say schools. No usamos la palabra de cuando especificamos algo. Si hablo de manera general, digo simplemente schools, computers, people. All right? An elephant is an animal. Yeah, what is the plural?
Hello.
Hello.
Elephant, hard animals.
Yeah, but we don't say hard, we say are. Elephants are animals. Excellent. Omit the letter A. A swan is a bird. A swan is a bird. What is the plural?
The swans are birds.
And what is the plural? Todo tengo que cambiar al plural.
The swans are birds.
Pero si tú dices a swans, estás diciendo un gansos son aves.
The swans are birds.
Ya no utilizo la palabra a, porque recuerda, la palabra a significa un, uno, una. Y solo se utiliza en singular. Puedo decir a swan, en singular. Un ganso, a swan. Pero si ya quiero decir en plural, ya omito la palabra a. Ya no puedo decir a swans, porque estaría diciendo un gansos. Simplemente digo swans are birds. ¿Ya? A y an son usados solo en singular. Si quiero cambiar al plural, omito la palabra a o an y aumento la letra s al sustantivo. Swans are birds. ¿Ya? Tell me, is this sentence correct? Carrots are vegetables. Is this sentence correct?
No.
No? Why?
Carrots are vegetables.
Vegetables, yeah. Is this correct or no? Carrots is in plural.
Carrots are vegetables.
Yes. Yeah, this is correct. Carrots is in plural. Are is in plural. Vegetables is in plural. So, this is correct. The sentence is correct. What about this? Bees is insects. Is this sentence correct?
No.
No? Why?
Bees are insects. No.
No, because we say bees are insects. This is incorrect. Yeah. Now, let's remind the use of the verb be. Hey, the verb be, it is a basic verb, right? Be has three forms. Am, is, and are. The verb be has three forms. Am, for example, I am a teacher. Are, it is used with you. You are a teacher. And is, it is the third form, and we say, she is a teacher, he is a teacher, it is a school. Here we have the three forms of the verb be, am, are, and is. All right? ¿Qué significa el verbo to be? Ser o estar. Y digo, yo soy un profesor, tú eres un profesor, él es un profesor. El verbo to be tiene tres formas, am, is, y are. So, we use am, siempre usamos am con I. Siempre usamos are con you, con we, y con they. Y siempre usamos is con he, she, it. We say, I'm a teacher, you are a teacher, she's a teacher, he's a teacher, it's a school. But in plural, we say, we are teachers, you are teachers, they are teachers. What happened here? Hey, in plural, we don't use a. ¿Por qué ya no utilizo a? Porque está en plural, aumento la S, pero quito la letra A. Remember, A and N, they are used with professions. Con las profesiones u ocupaciones, utilizamos siempre la palabrita A o N para el singular. Para el plural, omito la A y N, pero aumento el plural, la letra S de plural. Here we have a sentence. Hey, I, you, he, she, it, we, you, and they. This is the pronoun. Es el pronombre personal en English. The form of the verb be, am, are, and is. And the complement. In this case, the complement, it is a noun. I'm a teacher. We are teachers. And here we have a sentence. What is a sentence? ¿Qué significa sentence? Significa oración. ¿Qué clase de oración tengo aquí? Yo soy un profesor. Afirmativa, negativa o pregunta. I have here an affirmative sentence. Affirmative. ¿Qué tiene una oración? Tiene sujeto, verbo, complemento. Sujeto, verbo, complemento, like in Spanish. Para formar una oración necesito sujeto, verbo y complemento. And this is an affirmative sentence. ¿Con qué verbo? Con el verbo to be. I'm a teacher. Now, let's practice. We say, I'm a girl. You, ¿qué puedo decir? You are a girl, in singular. She,
she is a girl.
Girl. No decimos girl. Pay attention, no es E. We pronounce like E. Girl. She's a girl. In plural, we.
We are a girl.
Girls.
¿Qué dijimos del uso de a y an?
We are girls.
Girls. We are girls. Ya no utilizo aquí a. ¿Por qué no utilizo la a? Recuerden, la a significa un, uno, una. No puedo decir una chicas. Nosotros somos una chicas. ¿Verdad? You are girls and they are girls. A es usado en singular y para el plural elimino la A o N. And here we have the contraction. We can use contractions in affirmative sentences. Hey, the form to contract. The contraction of I and am, it is I'm. Y pronuncio la letra M. I'm. I'm a teacher. She and is, we say she's. She's a girl. He's a girl. It's a cat. For plural, you're, we're, and there. Pronunciation, it is not there. Pronunciation is there. There, students. Aquí ya no tengo la palabra a o an. ¿Por qué? Porque estoy en plural. I am solo utilizo en singular. My teacher is a woman. My teacher, this is the subject, es el sujeto. My teacher is, es el verbo, a woman, a complement. My teacher can be replaced by she. And we can say, she's nice. She's nice. My dog has four puppies. Four puppies can be replaced by they're. They're cute. Oh, ellos son hermosos. Ellos son preciosos. They're cute. ¿De quién estoy hablando? De los puppies. Right? I like you. You're friendly. I have two sisters. ¿Qué puedo decir aquí? What? I have two sisters. Use the subject. Use the pronoun. No? No idea? We're students. Now, look at this. This is a negative sentence. Here we have a negative sentence using the verb be. Para formar una oración negativa, hace un rato decía, yo soy un profesor. Yo soy un profesor. Ahora quiero decir, yo no soy un profesor. To change into a negative sentence, we need the word not. You see, this is the magic word, not. I'm not a teacher. And we can also use contractions. We say, I'm not a doctor. You're not a doctor. We have three forms to express negative sentences. Hey, puedo contraer de estas dos formas. You're not o you aren't. You're not, this is correct. You aren't, correct. O in the full form, we say, you are not a doctor. We have three forms to express negative sentences, yeah? She's not a doctor. This is full form. ¿Dónde aumenté la palabra not? Para formar una oración negativa, ¿dónde puse la palabra not? ¿Dónde está la palabra not? Vamos, ¿dónde? Hello.
Al lado del verbo.
Next to be. Next to be.
Exactly. Hey, está después del verbo to be. Para formar una oración negativa es facilito. Solo pongo la palabra not después del verbo to be. ¿Cuál es el verbo to be? Am, are, is. We say, she's not a doctor, she isn't a doctor. He's not a doctor, he isn't a doctor. It is not a city, it's not a city, or it isn't a city. In plural, we say, we are not doctors. ¿Qué pasó aquí? Ya le quité la palabra a. ¿Por qué? Porque ya tengo el plural. We are not doctors. In contraction, we aren't doctors. You are not teachers. You aren't teachers. They are not teachers. In contraction, they're not or they aren't. Negative forms. Yeah, let's see. The women, what do you think? Isn't, aren't.
Aren't.
Because this is in plural, the women aren't nurses. The affirmative? They?
They are doctors.
They are doctors. Excellent. The girl, what about this? The girl.
Aren't a teacher.
Yeah, but this girl, it is in plural or in singular?
Aren't a teacher.
Are es para el plural. Y aquí tengo this girl.
This girl is not a teacher.
Exactly. ¿Por qué utilizo isn't? ¿Por qué? Porque el sujeto de la oración está en singular. Girl es solamente esta chica. Una en singular. Are para el plural, is para el singular. Pero are también puede ser para el singular. Cuando digo you are a teacher. ¿Ya? Yeah? What about this? The affirmative sentence.
She is a student.
Excellent. She's a student. Yeah. And what about this?
This animal isn't a dog.
This animal isn't a dog. It's a cat. Excellent. Now, let's talk about adjectives. What is an adjective? Exactly like in Spanish. An adjective is a word used to describe a noun. What is the meaning of noun? Sustantivo. ¿Qué es el adjetivo? El adjetivo es aquella palabra que describe a los sustantivos. Exactly like in Spanish. So we say, an elephant is big, a butterfly is small, a ball is round, a fire is warm, Sarah is happy. Hey, here we have sentences, affirmative sentences. We say, an, it is only used with singular. Is. And the words, big, small, round, warm, and happy, these words are called adjectives because they qualify the noun, right? And now, we can form affirmative sentences using adjectives. We say, an orange is round in singular. Oranges are round. Pay attention to this. This is important. Oranges are round. Jane is young. Ada and Rob are intelligent. Pay attention. This sentence is in singular. This is in plural. This is in singular. This is in plural. What happened to the adjective? Hey, adjective, they are never pluralized. We can say, I'm happy. It's round. We are young. This adjectives, what happened here? Sorry. Los adjetivos en inglés nunca se pluralizan. Da lo mismo decir, I'm happy, we are happy. En inglés, los adjetivos nunca llevan plural. Siempre acuérdense esto, ningún adjetivo lleva plural. No puedo decir happy, ni young's, no. Adjectives are never pluralized. He's not clean. He's dirty. Right? Sisters aren't wet. They're dry. Okay, this is dry. Arid. What about this? The tree, what do you think? Is or are?
Is.
Is. Is what? Tall, short, young, old?
Is tall.
The tree is tall. Very good. And what about the bushes? These are the bushes. This and this, these are the bushes. And the bushes?
Are short.
Hace un ratito, los adjetivos no se pluralizan. No puedo decir shorts, porque los adjetivos nunca llevan plural. The bushes are short. Solo los sustantivos se pluralizan. Digo, un carro, dos carros, tres carros, cuatro carros, cinco estudiantes. Pero los adjetivos en inglés no se pluralizan. ¿Ok? Short. Ice cream, what? Ice cream
is cold.
Is cold. Excellent. Efire? What about this? A fire is warm. Okay, now, the verb be, we can use to form a sentence, we can use a place. We say, Janet is here. You are here. The students are here. Bill is at the library. Aquí ya tengo una oración. ¿Cómo formo una oración? Con sujeto, verbo y complemento. En este caso, el complemento puede ser un lugar. Con decir, Bill is in the park, ya tengo una oración con el verbo to be. Bill is at the library. Now, here and at the library, they express a place. What is a place? Es un lugar. And there are one word places, lugares que tienen una sola palabra. For example, Janet is here. Janet is there. What is there? Allí, lejos, allí. Janet is downtown. Janet is downstairs. What is downstairs? ¿Alguien sabe qué es downstairs? No, downstairs, es en el piso de abajo, downstairs. Upstairs is the opposite, en el piso de arriba. Janet está en el piso de arriba. Janet is outside, outside the class, and Janet is inside the class. What is inside? You are inside the class, dentro de. Janet is inside, outside, it is the opposite. Hey, Jonas is outside the tent. Look, it is upstairs. You see, está en el piso de arriba. And what about you? Are you upstairs or downstairs? Tell me, what about you? Upstairs or downstairs? Right, chicos, ¿dónde están ustedes? Enrique, please, could you help me? Luis, Diana, where are you? Upstairs or downstairs?
Downstairs.
Okay, but tell me the complete sentence. We are?
We are downstairs.
Excellent, thank you. What about Diana? Where is Diana?
It's upstairs.
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 Upstairs. Yeah, but pero dime la oración completa. Nosotros estamos en el piso de arriba. ¿Cómo sería?
Sería we are.
We are
upstairs.
Upstairs. Upstairs. We are upstairs. Okay, we are upstairs. Now we can also use prepositions and we say Sylvia is next to Jenny. Sylvia is next to Jenny. This is a prepositional phrase formed with a preposition and a noun. Next to. You understand what is next to? Cerca de Jenny. Sylvia is next to Jenny. Hera is in the pool. Leah is on the card. What is on? It means sobre. Leah is on the card. The plant is, these are prepositions. The plant is, where is the plant? Here is the plant.
Is on the table.
On the table, excellent. On significa in. In significa en. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre on e in? On significa en, pero cuando está sobre una superficie de algo. Por ejemplo, sobre la mesa es una superficie. Sobre la pared, el cuadro está en la pared, pero está sobre la pared, ¿no? Sobre una superficie, digo on. On the table, on the wall. Yeah. Max is what? Downtown. We can say downtown. Beth is what? At, under, next to, or on? To express a specific place, we say at. Beth is at the school. You are at the university. The table and chair are, what about this? No? No idea? What's the preposition we use here?
The table and chair are under the...
Under? Cuarto. It is under the tree. All right. Now, as a summary, what is a summary? Summary means un resumen. Como un resumen, basic sentences pairing with be. To form a sentence, we need subject, the verb be, and the complement. The complement could be a noun, for example, I'm a teacher. The subject could be an adjective. We can say, I'm happy. And the subject, I'm sorry, the complement could be a place. And we say, she's at the gym, I'm downstairs, I'm upstairs, with an expression of place. Right. So, an eagle is a bird. Is this sentence correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, this is correct. Singular, singular. Eggs is healthy. Is this correct?
No.
No, because eggs, it is in plural. Healthy, the verb should be in plural too. Eggs are healthy. China and Japan are countries, correct?
Yes.
Yes, plural and plural. The lion are big. No, because the lion is in singular, are is in plural. So the verb is incorrect. The lion is big. The boys is at the beach. Correct or incorrect?
No.
No.
No, because boys is in plural. So we have to use are. Is Chile a country? Now, here we have a question. This is very simple. A. To form a question, we need the form of the verb be and the first position. This is very easy. Here we have, is soccer a sport? This is a question. And soccer is a sport? This is an affirmative sentence. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre la pregunta y la oración afirmativa? ¿Qué pasó? En la oración afirmativa tengo el sujeto, el verbo y el complemento. En primera posición tengo el sujeto. Fútbol es un deporte. Para formar la pregunta, ¿qué hice?
puse el verbo to be antes del verbo.
Antes del sustantivo, antes del sujeto. Lo único que a cambio es el verbo to be y lo pongo en primera posición. ¿Es soccer sport? Y ya tengo mi pregunta. ¿Es Paris a country? No, Paris is a city. Here we have questions using the verb be. To form the question, at the beginning of the question, we need the verb be. Is, am, or are. Then we need the subject. Is Mark home? Yes, he is. What happened with the statement? This is the affirmative sentence. The subject is at the beginning and the verb be is after the subject. This is the difference. Question, the verb be, and the first position. Affirmative sentence, we use the subject and the first position. Are they bugs? They are bugs. For questions, the verb be before the subject. For statements or affirmative sentences, the subject and later the verb be. Okay? Now, look at this. I have here the answer. Yes, the baby is a girl. What is the question? Tengo la respuesta. ¿Cuál es la pregunta?
She is a girl.
No, porque dice la regla. En las preguntas, lo único que tengo que hacer es el verbo to be va delante del sujeto. Acá tengo, ¿cuál es el verbo to be? The baby is a girl. Is. Is es el sujeto. Por tanto, primerito va is. Luego va el sujeto. ¿Cuál es el sujeto? The baby.
Baby.
Ya, vamos. What is the question?
Is the baby
a girl?
Here.
Excellent. Is the baby a girl? Right. What about this? This is in plural. What's the question?
Are arms bones?
Box. Are ants box? Dice, ¿son las hormigas insectos? Yes, they're ants. They're bugs. What about this? Yes, ice cream is cold.
Is ice cream cold?
Excellent, Enrique. Thank you. Is George happy? To answer a question using the verb be, for example, is George happy? The short answer has the word yes plus the subject and the verb be. Yes, he is. In negative, remember, I'm sorry, in the short answers, we never use contractions. Las respuestas afirmativas cortas nunca se contraen. No puedo decir yes, he's. Las negatives, estas sí se contraen. Is he happy? No, he is not. This is correct. No, he isn't. This is correct. Are they bugs? Yes, they are. Afirmativas cortas nunca se contraen. Are you happy? Yes, I am. So, what about this? Are they correct? No, all of them are incorrect. No contractions with affirmative short answers. Yeah, what about this? What is the correct form of the verb be? Are you afraid of lions? Yes.
Yes. You are.
Ah, si la pregunta te hago directamente a ti, digo, hey, ¿tienes tú miedo a los leones? ¿Qué me respondes?
Yes,
sí.
I am.
Yes, I am. Sí, yo tengo miedo a los leones. Next.
Are.
Are.
Not.
I am not.
No, I'm not afraid of dogs. I like dogs. Excellent. Are limes sour? Continue. Hello. Is anyone there?
Yes.
Are limes? Yes. Pay attention. Are in plural. Limes in plural.
Yes.
So then.
Are.
It
is. They are?
Yes.
Yes, they are. Very good. Yes, they are because this is in plural. Continue, next.
Are limes red?
Are limes red? No, limes
are
green. Continue, orange. Are limes expensive?
No.
Okay.
No, they are.
They aren't.
Aren't.
Remember, en las oraciones negativas, prácticamente tengo dos palabras negativas. No, coma. Y viene acá, isn't or aren't, in plural. All right. Now, hey, look at this. Aquí tenemos, are limes sour? Preguntas, ¿no es cierto? ¿Cómo formaban las preguntas? Poniendo el verbo to be delante del sujeto. Estas preguntas se llaman yes, no questions. ¿Por qué se llaman yes, no questions? Porque la respuesta automáticamente es yes o no, o yes o no. Las yes no questions siempre inician con el auxiliar en primera posición. Are you a student? Yes, I am. Are you a dentist? No, I'm not. Are you a policeman? Yes, I am. So, these are yes no questions. Now, pay attention to this. Where is the glass? Ahora, ¿qué pasó aquí? Ya no tengo. Esta es una pregunta, pero no es una yes, no question. Cuando yo digo, ¿dónde está el vaso? La respuesta ya no será sí o no. Este tipo de preguntas se llama information questions. Information questions, they have the word what, where, when, who, how much, how many, etc. before the verb. Igual, para formar la pregunta, ¿qué hago? El verbo to be va delante del sujeto. Pero si la pregunta ya no es una yes, no question, sino una information question, delante del verbo to be irá la palabra interrogativa. ¿Cuáles son las palabras interrogativas? What, where, when, how much, how many, who, how, etc. Okay? This is a yes, no question. Is the glass on the table? Yes, it is. The glass is on the table. The long answer. Yes, no question. Porque la pregunta empieza con el verbo al principio y la respuesta automáticamente es yes or no. But now, are the glasses on the table? In plural. Yes, they are. The glasses are on the table. Long answer. But now, look at this. Where is the glass? Ahora ya pregunto por un lugar. ¿Dónde está el vaso? La pregunta es informativa. Estoy buscando una información. Where is the glass? Where is the... I'm sorry. Where is face the glass? The answer in this case, it is no, yes or no. The short answer, it is the information. Where is the glass? On the table. The glass is on the table. This is the long answer. You see that difference between yes, no question and information questions? Right? In plural, where are the glasses? On the table. The glasses are on the table. Long answer. So, information questions, they have what, where, when, etc. before the verb be. And then we use the subject and a question mark to form yes, no questions. I'm sorry, to form information questions. Is Tokyo in Japan? Yes, it is. Tokyo is in Japan. Yes, no question. Esta es una yes, no question. Because the answer, it is yes or no. But where is the boy? ¿Cuál es la short answer? ¿Qué dirían? Esta ya no es una yes, no question. La respuesta ya no será sí o no. La respuesta es la información que busco. Where is the boy? What? What is the answer? Okay, we are talking about this boy. Where is the boy?
Next to girl.
Okay, we can say next to the girl. Pero estoy preguntando por este niñito de acá. ¿Dónde está el chico? In the pool. And long answer? The boy is in the pool. Information question. Where is the bank? ¿Qué podríamos decir? Hey, where is the bank? It's down the street. And long answer, the bank is down the street. Down the street. Okay, now let's remember the use of have and has. I think this is in unit number 3. The use of have and has. I have a butterfly. We say, I have a book. You have a book. He has a book. He has a book. It has a red cover. Hey, this is in singular. Here we have the verb have. In plural, we have books. You have books. They have books. You see, in singular we use a book, pero en plural ya no digo a books. Ya quité el a o el an. ¿Por qué? Porque estoy en plural. No puedo decir nosotros tenemos un libros. Right? Now, this verb have and has significa tener. Yo tengo un libro. Yo tengo dos hermanos. Yo tengo tres hermanos. Pay attention to this. Con he, she, and it, we use the verb has. And we say, she has a book. He has a book. It has a red cover. Con he, she, and it, we use has. With I, you, we, and they, we use the form of the verb have, the complete form. Now, look at this. I have, you have, we have, they have. And I can say, I have one brother. You have two brothers. We have five sisters. They have one boy. For he, she, and it, we use the verb has. We say, she has one brother, he has two brothers, it has one leg, for example. Now, has, porque tiene la letra S aquí, no significa plural. Verá que he, she, and it Esto es singular en tercera persona. Para él, para ella o para aquello. En este caso utilizo has. La S no significa plural. Right? And I say, hey, Jane, what? Has or have?
Has.
Has, because this is James in singular. Third person. They
have
12 grandchildren. The girl, 5 sisters.
Has.
Because it is the third person. You
have
a special grammar book. Excellent. Now, let's talk about the possessive adjectives. What is a possessive adjective? ¿Qué son adjetivos posesivos? Hey, in English, we have 3 forms to express possession. Para expresar posesión en inglés, tenemos algunas formas. Una de ellas son los possessive adjectives. ¿Cuáles son los possessive adjectives? My, your, his, her, it's, our, and their. These are the possessive adjectives. For example, this hat belongs to me. Hey, we can say it is my hat. Cuando yo digo este es mi celular, este es mi cuaderno, estoy expresando posesión. Para indicar posesión de la primera persona, the I, we use my, my hat. To express possession of the second person, it means you, we say it is your hat. Este es tu sombrero. ¿De quién? De usted. De usted en singular. Esta es tu clase. That hat belongs to him. What is him? The él. It is his hat. What is his? His significa su. ¿Pero de quién? De él. Este es su sombrero, pero este su se refiere a un hombre. This is his hat. Now, every possessive adjective, okay, correspond to a subject pronoun. So, for I, we use my. El possessive adjective de you is your. For he, we use his. To talk about she, we use her. For it, it is its. Pero ponga atención a este its. Este its no tiene apóstrofe. Es la I, la T y la S. Cuando no tiene el apóstrofe, este es un possessive adjective. Y significa su. ¿Pero su de quién? Su de it. Su de aquello. Este it representa a objetos, animales o cosas en singular. Puede decir su, pero su de un objeto, de un animal, de una cosa. The possessive adjective for we, it is our, and for they, it is, they, it is their, right? So we say, my hat. Los possessive adjectives siempre van junto al sustantivo, obvio. Si yo quiero expresar posesión, digo, este es mi cuaderno, este es mi celular, este es mi profesor. My hat, my cell phone, my course, my teacher. Pero si digo, este es tu profesor, digo, your teacher. Si digo, este es su profesor, me estoy refiriendo a Enrique. Su de Enrique, ¿cuál será? His. Refiero y digo, hey, chicos, este es su cuaderno, pero me estoy refiriendo al cuaderno de Diana. ¿Diana qué es? Es una mujer. Diana es lo mismo que she. ¿Cuál será el su para Diana? Her. Y digo, this is her book. Este es su teacher. Cuaderno de ella. ¿Yes?
Teacher, una pregunta.
Ajá.
En la página número 12 del libro que tenemos, aquí para aquí, está utilizando her. Y como usted nos pone en la pantalla, tenemos al contrario, porque es he para his, para he. Para el hombre, his, y para la mujer está her. Mientras que en el libro tenemos her para varón y his para mujer.
No, puede ser. A ver, ¿qué dice exactamente el ejercicio? No tengo yo el libro a la mano.
Por ejemplo, en la unidad 2, en la página 12, dice possessive uh-huh. adjectives.
Possessive
adjectives. He, his, her boss.
He is her boss.
Ajá.
Dice así, he is her boss, ¿ya?
Okay. Y luego dice Teresa is his colleague.
Ajá, colleague.
Yes.
¿Ya? Pay attention. Hey, don't go. Espérate, no te me vayas.
Sí, pero tienes que ver que lo que pasa es que al lado hay más escrito y ahí te está poniendo los subject pronoun y possessive adjective. Ahí lo que está utilizando, es los posesivos adjetivos para referirse a otra persona. No es un error del libro. Tú estás mirándole desde otro, como tú estás equivocada. Tienes que verle en la esquinita. Está hablando de otra persona.
Sí, a eso voy. Verán, chicos. A ver, repíteme el ejercicio que tú encontraste, mija. ¿Qué dice tu ejercicio? He is her boss. ¿Así está el ejemplo?
Yes, dice he is her boss.
Yeah. What's your name, my dear? What's your name?
My name is Alexandra.
Yeah, Alexandra. This is the example. He is her boss. ¿Y el otro ejemplo que decía?
Teresa is his colleague.
Teresa is his colleague. Right? Así está el ejemplo. ¿Sí o no? Yeah. ¿Qué dice aquí mi vida? Aquí tengo una oración que dice, él es su jefe, pero ¿su jefe de quién? Her significa su, pero ¿de quién? Su de una mujer. Entonces, imagínate que acá tengo su jefe, él es su jefe, pero jefe de María. María es la jefe, ¿no es cierto? Estamos hablando de que el jefe es una mujer. Él es su jefe. O sea, el jefe de él es una mujer. A eso se refiere. ¿Sí, sí le... me hago entender? Mira qué dice acá, Teresa. Teresa es el sujeto. Is el verbo to be. Teresa es el sujeto. Is el verbo to be. His colleague. ¿Qué significa his? Vamos, ¿qué significa his? His es el possessive adjective. Su, pero ¿de quién?
De un hombre.
De un hombre. Entonces aquí dice, Teresa es su colega. Estamos hablando de un hombre aquí. Imaginemos que estamos hablando de Enrique. Teresa es su colega. O sea, Teresa es el colega de Enrique. Estamos hablando aquí de Enrique, de un hombre. No sé si me hago entender. His and her. Hey, his and her significan su. ¿Pero su de quién? Este her significa su de ella. Y este his significa su, pero de él. El sujeto es otra persona. Su colega, ¿pero de quién? Su colega de él. Tengo a dos chicos conversando aquí. ¿Dónde tengo una foto de dos chicos? Puede ser. Una foto de dos chicos conversando. Aquí tengo dos personas conversando. ¿Ok? Y yo digo él. Esta es María, él es José y él es el hijo Pedro. ¿Ya? Y digo, hey, Pedro es su hijo. Pero si me refiero al hijo de María, ¿cómo diría? Quiero decir, Pedro es su hijo, pero quiero especificar que es el hijo de María. ¿Cómo digo, Pedro es su hijo?
Pedro is her.
Ajá. Her son. Pedro is her son. ¿Pero su de quién?
De María.
De María. Pero ahora yo quiero decir, hey, Pedro es su hijo. Pero me quiero referir a que Luis es el papá. A su, pero de Luis. ¿Cómo Pedro diría allí?
Pedro is his son.
His son. ¿De quién estoy hablando?
Del papá de Pedro.
José. Del papá de Pedro, o sea, de José. José. Entonces puedo decir, mira, Pedro es su hijo, refiriéndome a María. También puedo decir, Pedro es su hijo, refiriéndome a José. Si me refiero a María, que es una mujer, digo her. Si me refiero a Pedro, perdón, si me refiero a José, que es un hombre, digo his. ¿Ya? Vamos a ver otro ejemplo. Digo, ¿dónde estaba? ¿Ya? Digo, tengo un celular. Ya, este celular. Si digo, este celular es, no, este es su celular, pero, hey, este es su celular de Luis. ¿Cómo diría?
Móvil is his.
Puedo decir, hey, this, este, este es.
His
este es su celular, pero hey, pay attention. Este es el celular de Enrique. Digo, ¿de quién es este celular? Y por ahí Diana me dice, hey, es su celular, pero ese es su celular de Enrique. ¿Cómo me diría? This is.
This is his.
His cell. This is his cell phone. Pero resulta que el celular ahora es de Diana.
He is her cell.
Y digo, hey, este es su celular, pero me estoy refiriendo a Diana. This is her cell.
Her cell.
Ajá. Y digo, Teresa es su colega, pero ¿es su colega de quién?
De un hombre.
De un hombre. Teresa es el colega, pero ¿de quién? De un hombre. Y digo, he is her boss. Él es su jefa. ¿De quién? De ella. De una mujer. All right. So, these are the possessive adjectives. So, this is my bicycle. You own that backpack? ¿De quién me estoy hablando? Dice, tú eres dueño o posees esa mochila. Entonces, esta es tu mochila, your backpack. We own these flowers. These are. Si nosotros poseemos estas flores, ¿qué son? Estas son.
Your flowers?
No, because the subject it is we. Our flowers.
Our.
Exactly. Para we use our. Yeah, my apple is red. Again, I have an apple. We can say, my apple is red. If you have an apple, your apple is red. For the subject I, the possessive form, it is my. For you, the possessive form is your. For she, The possessive, it is her. For he, the possessive is his. He has an apple. His apple is red. He significa su, de él. Her significa su, pero de ella. Para we, in plural, we use our. In plural, for you, we use their, your. And for they, the possessive form, it is their. Okay? Remember, possessive adjectives, they are always before nouns. Their apples, my apple. Yeah, what about Luigi is wearing shoes? Yeah, mira lo que dice. Luigi is wearing shoes. ¿Qué diré?
His shoes are black.
¿Por qué digo his?
Porque estamos hablando de él.
De Luigi, exacto, dice. Luigi está usando zapatos. Y digo, ah, sus zapatos son negros. Pero su, ¿de quién? De él, de Luigi. So we use his shoes are black. Elena and Gina are wearing jeans. Jeans are blue. What is the correct possessive adjective?
Their
jeans. Este their, ¿a quién me refiero? A Elena and Gina. A ellas. She's wearing boots.
Her
boots are old. Porque este dice, sus botas son viejas. Pero su de quién? De sus ella. Botas de quién? De ella. De ella. Exactly. John is wearing a hat.
His
hat is blue. Excellent. Right. Now, Ben, have or has?
His.
No, first of all, we have to use the verb. Ben. Ben, have
has.
A coat
has.
Or Ben has.
Has
a coat? Has a coat.
Has.
Now, what is the possessive adjective?
His
coat is brown. Excellent. Hey, su abrigo. ¿De quién? De Ben. Stephen Leah.
Have.
Their car is old. Su carro, pero su carro de quién? De Steve y de Leah, que son they. Susan.
Has
a book.
Her
book. Su libro, pero de quién? Su de quién?
Susan.
De Susan. Excellent. Oh, my goodness. Now, hey, estos, I have here more examples, but I want to explain the imperatives. Pay attention. Oh. Tengo que llegar a los imperatives. Espérense. Let me explain about the imperatives. Here we have the use of this. Later, we continue with this. Oh, we have a lot of. Let me talk about the imperatives, yeah? This is negatives. We have 10 minutes to continue with this. Let me talk about imperatives. Déjenme llegar a los imperatives, que no quiero que se me vayan sin la explicación de imperatives. Yeah, imperatives. Right. Here we have imperative sentences. What is an imperative? ¿Qué es un imperativo? Es una orden. Es algo que tiene que obedecer. Es una instrucción, una orden, es un comando. It is something we have to obey. It is a command. For example, an example of an imperative, it is, hey, stand up. When someone says, stand up, ¿qué es eso? Es una orden. Chicos, pónganse de pie. Una orden. Cuando digo, cierren el libro, es una orden. In English, we call imperatives. Now, how do we form imperatives? Los imperativos no tienen la misma estructura de la oración afirmativa. Los imperativos solamente tienen el verbo y el complemento. Right? We have imperatives, polite imperatives. For example, be quiet. Les digo, chicos, hagan silencio. ¿Qué es eso? Es una orden, es un imperativo. Es un comando, una instrucción. All right? An imperative, it is something we have to obey. Algo que debemos obedecer. When I say, please be quiet, this is the imperative sentence. What does it mean? It means, I want you to be quiet. Yo quiero que ustedes estén quietos. So, in this case, we use imperative sentences. Now, how do we form imperatives? Only with the principal verb and the complement. We say, stand up, take the bus to the bank, walk to the pharmacy, drive to the school. This is an imperative sentence. Imperatives, they only have the form of the verb. Para formar los imperativos, solo necesito el verbo y el complemento, si es que tuviera. Si les digo, hey, chicos, camine a la farmacia. María, camina a la farmacia. Es una orden, camina a la farmacia. To form imperatives, we don't use the subject. Aquí no necesito un sujeto, no digo... María walked to the pharmacy. Para darle una orden, no digo, hey, no utilizo un sujeto, sino simplemente el verbo y el complemento. Digo, hey, open the book, close the book, open the door, stand up, sit down. This is an imperative. Imperatives, they have only the verb and the complement, right? Now, these are affirmative imperatives. Porque le estoy diciendo, hey, abre la puerta, cierra la puerta. Affirmatives. But we also have negative imperatives. Cuando digo, hey, chicos, no hablen en clase. Don't speak in class. No hablen en español. Don't speak in Spanish. This is a negative. This is an order, an imperative, but the imperative is negative. Don't drive so fast. Don't go out tonight. Don't take the bus. Don't walk to school. So to form imperatives in negative, we use don't at the beginning and then the simple form of the verb. And that's it. Here we have the imperative. Now, when do we use imperatives? Imperatives are used to give orders. For example, come here. Come here, Maria. Come here, Diana. Ven acá, Diana. Come here. An order. It is also used to give directions. For example, where is the pharmacy? How do I go to the pharmacy? And you say, hey, turn left, turn right, go straight ahead. To give directions, we use the verb and the complement. Turn left, gire a la izquierda, gire a la derecha, vaya recto, go straight ahead. To give advice. What is the meaning of advice? It means consejo. Para dar un consejo, we use an affirmative or negative. In this case, don't be upset. And requests. What is the meaning of requests? Pedidos. Para hacer pedidos, we can use the word please. Please, it is very common. It is a very common word used with imperatives because we say, please, give me the book. Please, open the door. Please close the door. Please open the book. Right? The word please, it is a polite, to form polite requests. So here we have some imperative verbs. You say, please go to the store. The imperative. And the second, okay, what do we need? Gina says, buy some milk and bread. Aquí tengo otro imperative. Compra leche y pan. Buy some milk and bread. This is an order, a command. Don't start the movie without me. This is in negative. Okay? Now, how do you go to work? When we want to express means of transportation, right? In Spanish we say, yo voy al trabajo, yo voy a la universidad en bus, voy en taxi, voy en bicicleta, voy en motocicleta. We use the preposition in. In English, no. In English, we use the preposition by. And I say, I go to work by bus, I go to work by taxi, I go to work by car, by bicycle, by motorcycle. Remember, we use by to express means of transportation. Or you can say, how do you go home? I walk. Okay? Oh my goodness. Unfortunately, the class is over. It is 10 o'clock. Did you understand the use of imperatives? ¿Quedó claro la explicación de los imperatives? ¿O no? Vamos a ver quién. ¿Sí? ¿Se aclaró un poco la explicación de los imperatives?
Sí, teacher, muchas gracias. A mí sí, sí me sirvió más de lo que la licenciada que tengo en la plataforma, porque en serio me mandó videos, pero la verdad es que no. Ahorita le entendí más cómo poner en práctica.
All right, very good. So, give me some examples of imperatives. ¿Qué me podrías hacer? Dime some examples.
Un ejemplo sería, don't drink beer.
Don't drink beer. Exactly. Hey, don't drink beer. Right. What else? Another example. Give me more examples. Alguien que le ayude a la amiga, ver, give me more examples of imperatives. No? No? When I say, for example, wait for me.
One example, finish the class.
Exactly. Teacher, yes, finish the class.
Hello, hello. Here we have.
Hurry up. You can say, teacher, hurry up. Yeah. Here I have some examples. Unfortunately, it is not clear. Sit down. Be careful. Students, be careful. Don't open the window. Don't be late. Stop. Don't worry. Please close the door. Yeah, unfortunately, I can. Okay, let me see. I have here some examples, right? See? Negatives. Don't open the window, don't be late. Orders, stop, open, don't worry. Wait for me. Wait for me. Hurry up. These are imperatives. More examples, let me see. I have here some examples, but... No. I have some examples to complete. Yeah. What can you say in this case? ¿Qué dirían en este caso?
Do not move the TV.
Don't move the TV? Well, it could be. What else? ¿Qué más podrían decir? What can you say about this? Give an order. Para mí que ella quiere que él prenda la computadora y le está dando una orden. ¿Qué le dice? La televisión. ¿Qué le dice usted a su hermano menor? ¡Ey! ¡Prende la televisión! ¿Cómo digo prende la tele?
Turn on the TV.
Exactly. ¡Ey! Turn on the TV. Right. And this? Tell me the imperative. What about this picture? What can you say about this picture? This is a patient, he is the dentist. ¿Qué le diría? El dentista al paciente. Don't be afraid. No tengas miedo. And this, what happened about this? What do you think? No idea? ¿Qué cree que le pueda decir este señor acá al otro? ¿No? Be careful. Ten cuidado. Hey, be careful. No idea? No? Okay. Again, it would be careful. Well, my dear students, thank you very much for attending this first face-to-face class. For me, it was a pleasure to work with you. I think it is, 10 and 7, right. Thank you and bye-bye. See you next class.
Teacher.
All right,
you're welcome.
Try to use your English. ¿Cómo me dirían en inglés?
Thank you for the class.
Thank you for the class. Right, excellent. See you. Hey, see you next time. This is an imperative. Nos vemos. See you. Imperative. See you next class. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, teacher.